Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to enable device portal on Windows 11 operating system. So Windows device portal is basically a device management and debugging tool that lets you configure and manage device settings and view diagnostic information from your PC over HTTP. So previously I have shared you the video to enable developer mode and you can check out that video on this card. Now if you have already enabled developer mode, here I will show you how you can enable device portal. So first we will open settings app. In the settings app, go to system, then for developers. Here you can see that the developer mode is already turned on. Now we will turn on the device portal option. Simply turn on the device portal option and there appears a pop-up: installed Windows developer mode package. Turning on device portal will install the Windows developer mode package. Turn on device portal, and as soon as you click on yes, you will see this notification: we are adding a new feature to Windows. This could take a minute. If you click on that notification, you will be taken to optional features page where you will find Windows developer mode package is being installed. It may take a while to install this. Make sure you remain connected to the internet while doing this. Few moments later, you can see that Windows developer mode package has been installed successfully. Now we can go back to the for developers page, and here you can see that the device portal option is now turned on. You can expand it, and here you have the connect using localhost and Ethernet 0 links at the bottom, and you can click on edit against the provide a username or password. And here you can see that the authentication option is turned on, but a username or password is not set yet. So you can just click on the edit button here and set a username and password for device portal page. In the confirmation prompt, click yes. And finally, the username and password has been set for the device portal. Now you can just click on the localhost link there, and this will open in a default web browser. Since this is HTTP page, some browsers may show warning as it is a local device page. So you can just simply select continue with an unsecured connection if you are using Microsoft Edge, and continue to the localhost page. Now type in the username and password we have just set earlier in this video. You can also save this password to the browser if you regularly access the Windows device portal page. Now here you can see that the Windows device portal page has been loaded. There are few options like app manager. You can use app manager to see which apps are running. File explorer tab is here. You can use that tab to work with file explorer. You can also locate the running processes under running processes tab. Then for performance, you can see the live graphs of CPU, input, output, memory, network, GPU. Under debugging, you can see the dump processes, logs, if they are located. Then you can see ETW logging. Then you can also go to device manager tab to locate all the devices connected. On the Bluetooth tab, Bluetooth devices will be shown. On the networking tab, Wi-Fi networks will be shown. So in this way, we have successfully enabled the device portal on Windows 11, and you can use it for your development environment. That's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.